A father of two is recovering in hospital this morning after being attacked by a shark on the New South Wales mid-north coast. Live 2 Nine's James Wilson in Port Macquarie. James, good morning. He underwent surgery overnight.
That's right, Sophie. 44-year-old Toby Begg is in a critical but stable condition at John Hunter Hospital following a second surgery yesterday night. We brought you those incredible images of him touching down at John Hunter Hospital yesterday evening, airlifted by the Westpac rescue helicopter, wrapped in blankets, sedated. It's been an incredible job by these medical professionals to stabilise him and sustain him up until this point. Of course, this all follows a horrific shark attack here at Lighthouse Beach around 10 a.m. yesterday morning. The father of two, Toby, was surfing around 150 metres offshore with a group of other people when a 4-metre great white shark latched onto his legs. Toby fought this animal for 30 seconds as he battled his way into shore. That is when these good Samaritans, these heroes, leapt into action, including an off-duty ED doctor. They used a surf leg rope to tourniquet him and stem the bleeding. Both police and paramedics say the actions of those here yesterday undoubtedly saved his life up until this point. Of course, this was a harrowing scene for many, many witnesses, some of those people we spoke to yesterday morning.
Something quite big and the guy getting attacked, a bit confronting, for all of us.
He was bleeding everywhere. They were trying to talk to him. He was silent. He was just frozen. They tried to tie his leg with a leg rope from the surfboard together and some sticks to keep it straight.
Sophie, both the DPI and Surf Life Saving New South Wales patrolled these waters yesterday. They still haven't seen any sign of the shark. The reason we know it's a 4-metre great white is also because of witness accounts, but the bite marks to Toby's surfboard. You can see it here, this fiberglass surfboard bitten in three. You can just imagine how powerful this shark's jaws were during this attack. At the moment, the beaches remain closed this morning. We are seeing a number of locals come down and enjoy the sunrise, but certainly nobody in the water. Of course, Toby is a local man, well-known father of two, and this attack is certainly causing ripple effects and heartache in this community as he continues to fight for life. Sophie.
James Wilson in Port Macquarie for us this morning. Thank you.
A surfer tried desperately to fight off a shark for 30 seconds after suffering significant injuries in this brutal attack off the New South Wales mid-north coast. The incident again raising water safety fears as we head into those warmer months. Let's bring in shark expert Marc Payne from Esperance in WA. Marc, good morning. Thanks for your time on Weekend Today. What more do we know about this attack this morning?
Well, I'm not... to me, it's quite familiar with some of the attacks we've had in Western Australia. For one, it appears like the shark was of a reasonable size, somewhere around that sub-adult range. And for two, it seems quite persistent. So, I mean, there's a bit of similarity there to some of the events we've had over here. But also, I think during these early stages with ocean safety, what we really try and focus on is supporting the victim and supporting their family and, supporting the people around that were there in the rescue. But also, I mean, these events, I come from a small community that's been affected quite a lot by these types of events. And it does impact on everybody involved. It sort of opens old wounds as well. Mm. So, I just think at this stage, we just really need to respect the situation and show our support.
Hey, Marc, one of the most striking images from this attack is the surfboard itself. There it is there. It's split in two. What does that tell us about the brutality of this particular incident or attack?
Look, I think for a shark that size, that's nothing unusual. You're talking about a very powerful predator. And, that doesn't really give the intent of what happened. It's just a surfboard with a bite out of it from a large shark. So, I wasn't there, so I don't know exactly what happened. But these animals are very powerful and capable of doing a lot. They're also highly inquisitive. So it's not difficult for that, something like that to happen.
So I'd love to ask you about shark sightings because they have increased along the New South Wales coastline in recent years. Is there ever any evidence to suggest what's behind the rise?
Oh, look, for me personally, I come from in the early days when we used to hunt and kill sharks. And I've seen the change from going from that to the protection and then the situation now. So I think it's more about Just the way we, see sharks, the way, sharks seem to be a lot more cooler nowadays. People are much more aware of sharks. So I think it's more of a trend, a human trend towards, the way we treat the animal and the way we go about protecting and, mitigation and all that type of stuff. So, there's been a big change in human behaviour around sharks over the past 3 or 4 decades.
Hey, Marc, just to finish very quickly, we're about to move into the warmer months, spring, summer. Are attacks more common in warmer weather, warmer waters?
Yeah, look, springtime is a time of the year like it is on the land, like everything flourishes. So, all your seagrasses and microorganisms and all flourish away, and then along comes all the bait fish, all the rivers fill up with bait. So it's just a time of the year when all these events are happening, just like it does on the land. And, the sharks are top predators in this arena. So you've got to expect to get more interactions.
Yeah, be warned. Marc, thank you so much for your time on Weekend Today.
A man is in a critical but stable condition in hospital this morning after he was attacked by a shark on the New South Wales mid-north coast. Nine's James Wilson is in Port Macquarie this morning. James, what's happening at the beach there today?
Good morning, Sophie. What almost feels like business as usual down here at Lighthouse Beach at Port Macquarie. This is where 44-year-old father of two, Toby Begg, was mauled by that 4-metre great white shark yesterday morning. Today we've seen people come down and enjoy the sunrise. We've also seen some surfers venture back out into the ocean. I'm joined by surf life-saving drone pilot Josh Lawrence. You were down here yesterday. Firstly, take me back to that response from firstly the community, the surfers, and of course then the first responders like paramedics and yourself. It was quite remarkable.
Yeah, good morning, James. So amazing effort by everyone on scene yesterday. The initial response from the surfers and bystanders on the beach, and then once paramedics arrived, obviously they all did an amazing job to stabilise and get the patient to hospital.
Now, you put a drone up yesterday searching for this shark. Tell me a bit about that operation and what you discovered.
Yeah, so upon receiving news of the attack, lifeguards and the UAV pilots were on scene. We quickly closed the beach, got everyone out of the water and sent the drone up to look for anything in the area. We did have one shark sighting, but upon review with DPI, they've informed us that that was likely not the shark involved.
So what's the plan for today? I understand the beaches have been closed since the attack around 10:30 yesterday morning. You're about to go for another patrol to make sure the waters are safe to go back in?
Yeah, correct. So in an incident like this, we closed the beach for around 24 hours. And then we'll do another flight this morning, make sure that the area is all clear. And then, upon nothing being in the area, we will reopen the beach.
Thanks very much for your time. Sophie, that drone surveillance is going to happen in the next half an hour. Meanwhile, 44-year-old father Toby Begg is still in a critical but stable condition at John Hunter Hospital after undergoing surgery on his legs. It really is still touch and go at the moment.
Yeah, our thoughts are with him and his family. James, thank you.